learning, reading namaz, and all sorts of Islamic things.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
Namaz, Qiyamah ki dhoom mein saaya hai.
There's learning time and sunnah time and praying time and naaz time. There's always such a great time and it's mini meme time. It's mini meme time with the meza.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين عما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي زدني علما السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Allah's name I begin with the most kind and merciful Today is our 30th program and today we have a very special topic. The topic for today is the topic of two countries, India and Pakistan. So these two countries, they border each other and before they used to be one country. Then they got their Independence Day on August 14th, that's for Pakistan, and August 15th, this is for India. So August 14 and August 15 are known as the Independence Day of Pakistan and India. That's why we're going to be talking about both the countries. So my relationship with both of these countries is that my parents were born in Pakistan, but one of my grandfathers, he was born in India. So that's why I have related to Pakistan. So let's get the introduction of our participants and know what relationship they have with their countries. Okay.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Aisha. I'm a Canadian but my background belongs to India.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Moina Sheikh and I'm Canadian and my background belongs to India.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Abdul Hadi. I'm Canadian and my background belongs to Pakistan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Maz. I am a Canadian and my background belongs to Pakistan.
Okay, mashallah. Now, since we know where you guys are from and we know your names now, let's head over to our quiz. So are you guys ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, so let's begin, starting with you, Aisha. What is the capital of India?
The capital of India is New Delhi.
Yes, that is correct. Okay, Moina, who is known as the poet of the East?
The poet of the East is known by Allama Iqbal.
Yes, that is correct. He is from Pakistan. Okay, Abdul Hadi. How many provinces are there in Pakistan?
There are four provinces in Pakistan, those of which are Balochistan, Sindh, Punjab, and Sarhad.
That is correct. Okay, and what is the capital city of Pakistan, Maz?
The capital city of Pakistan is Islamabad.
That is correct. Okay, Aisha, back to you. What is the national bird of India?
The national bird of India is a peacock.
That is correct. And Moina, which continent are Pakistan and India located in?
They are located in Asia.
Okay, Abdul Hadi and Moina, you're correct. Abdul Hadi, what is the national animal of Pakistan?
Marhor is the national animal of Pakistan.
That is correct. And Maz, how many official languages are spoken in Pakistan?
There are five official languages spoken in Pakistan. Urdu, Balochi,
Sindhi,
Saiki,
and Saraiki,
and Punjabi.
Punjabi and Pashto. So obviously there's a lot of languages spoken all over the world, but these are the main languages that are spoken in Pakistan. Okay, Aisha. What is the currency of India and Pakistan?
The currency for India and Pakistan are rupees, but they both have different values.
Yes, that is correct. And who, okay, Moina, this one's for you. Who had the Taj Mahal built?
The Taj Mahal was built, the beautiful Taj Mahal was built by Shah Jahan for, in his, in his, um, in, in his wife memory, her wife, his wife name was Mumtaz Mahal.
Yes.
Her memory.
Yes, in her memory, the Taj Mahal, which is a very, very beautiful place located in India, it was built by Shah Jahan. Okay, Abdul Hadi, who was the founder of Pakistan?
The founder of Pakistan was Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jawahiri.
Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So, yes, yeah. You are correct, Abdul Hadi. Okay, Maz, this question is for you. Name a few of Pakistan's beautiful and wondrous buildings and locations.
The Pakistan Monument, Lahore Fort, Faisal Masjid, Badshahi Masjid, and Mohenjo-Daro in Minare, Pakistan.
Yes, that is correct. But obviously, there are many, many more. Okay, Aisha, fourth question for you. Which countries border India?
The countries are Nepal, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, China, Myanmar, and Sri Lanka.
That is 100% correct. Okay, Moina, which countries border Pakistan?
The country border Pakistan is India, China, Afghanistan, and Iran.
Yes, India, Iran, Afghanistan, and China. Okay, Abdul Hadi, this question is for you. Which sea touches Pakistan's border?
The Arabian Sea touches Pakistani borders.
That is correct. And Maz, do you know the national colors of Pakistan?
Yeah, the green, the dark green, it represents the...
Do you need a bit of help?
Yeah.
It represents the majority of people that live there. Do you know which people?
The Pakistan. No.
The majority of which religion is in Pakistan?
Islam.
Yes. So it represents the Islam and the minority religions.
The minority is the white color.
Yes. For all the other religions in Pakistan, you are correct, Maz. Okay, Aisha, what is India's most recognizable building?
It is Taj Mahal.
Yes, as Moina has mentioned, it is Taj Mahal. Okay, Moina, last question for you too. What are the names of some of the most famous awliyas that are in India?
So in Delhi, in Ajmer, it's Hazrat Khwaja Moinuddin Chishti radhiyallahu ta'ala an, and in Delhi, it's Hazrat Nizamuddin Awliya radhiyallahu ta'ala an, and in Bareilly, it's Hazrat Imam Ahmad Reza.
That is correct, and there are many, many more famous awliya located in India. Okay, Abdul Hadi, what are the names of some of the awliyas in Pakistan?
In Lahore, Hazrat Usman Ali Jawahiri. In Karachi, Abdullah Shah Ghazi. In Islamabad, Pir Meher Ali Shah, and many more.
Yes, you are correct, Abdul Hadi. And Maz, who composed the verses of Pakistan National Anthem?
Hafiz Jalandhari composed the verses of the national anthem in Pakistan.
That is correct. Well then, that ends off our quiz round. I hope you guys got to learn something new about these two wonderful countries. So let's get to learn more, but we'll be back after a short break, so stay tuned.
साफ सुथरा और पाकीज़ा चैनल फैमिली के तमाम मेंबर्स के साथ देखते रहिए मीम टीवी।
हमको अल्लाह और नबी से प्यार है, इंशाअल्लाह अपना बेड़ा पार है। बोलो हमको अल्लाह
Shabbat مسجد اکثر پچھلے کئی سالوں سے کمیونٹی کی خدمت کرتی ہے، جس میں پانچ وقت نمازوں کا انعقاد، جمعے کی نمازوں کے لیے تین تین جماعتوں کا انتظام، اور اس کے علاوہ رمضان المبارک میں تراویح کا انتظام اور افطاریوں کا سلسلہ، ویکلی اسلامک اسکول جس کے ذریعے 150 بچے تعلیم حاصل کرتے ہیں، آپ ہی کے دیے ہوئے چندے آپ ہی کے تعاون سے چلتے ہیں۔
لاک ڈاؤن کے پیش نظر اخراجات میں ان کے رینٹ میں آپ کے بھرپور تعاون کی ضرورت ہے۔ کیش، چیک یا ویزا یا ڈیبٹ کے ذریعے اپنی پیمنٹ دینا چاہیں، وہ انشاءاللہ تبارک و تعالیٰ اسکرین پر موجود ڈیٹیل کے ذریعے اپنا گھر بیٹھے حصہ ڈال سکتے ہیں۔
مولا کرم 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 مولا کرم کرم مولا کرم 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 مولا کرم کرم مولا۔
السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ، ویلکم بیک آفٹر شارٹ بریک۔ ناؤ وی ہیو ٹو سیگمنٹس، آور اسٹوری ٹیلنگ راؤنڈ اینڈ آور بونس کوسچن راؤنڈ۔ سو لیٹس بگن ود آور اسٹوری۔ آور اسٹوری از اباؤٹ حضرت ابو ہریرہ رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ اینڈ دا باؤل آف ملک۔ So this story contains a very, very famous mu'jiza performed by our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So stick around to see what it was. So it begins as one day Hazrat Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was feeling a bit hungry, so he sat down by a very commonly used path. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu passed by, and Hazrat Abu Hurairah asked him the meaning of a certain ayat. His main intention was that Hazrat Abu Bakr would see that he is hungry and maybe invite him to come eat food. But Hazrat Abu Bakr, he just told him the translation of the ayat and he moved along. Then after that, Hazrat Umar passed by and the same situation happened. He asked him about the ayah with the intention of him realizing that Hazrat Abu Hurairah was hungry. But Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhum, he also told the translation and he walked by. Then finally, our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he passed by. Now our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has great knowledge and he knows about everything, so our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by his knowledge, he knew that Hazrat Abu Hurairah was hungry. So our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he called on Hazrat Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu and told him to come to his house. In our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's house, there was one bowl of milk that has been sent to our holy prophet as a gift. Our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he then told Hazrat Abu Hurairah to gather the people of Ashab al-Suffa. Now Ashab al-Suffa is like a small platform where the Sahaba Karam would learn ilm al-Deen from our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this place is located in Medina. So Hazrat Abu Hurairah, he thought to himself that there's only one bowl of milk. Our holy prophet is inviting all the sahabas of the Ashab al-Suffa, and how is everyone going to drink from one bowl of milk, right? It's just a small bowl and 70 sahaba. How are they all going to drink from one bowl? And he thought that he was the most righteous of this bowl of milk, since he was in a way very hungry. But since he had no other way, he obeyed our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as he would usually do, and he brought all the sahaba from the Ashab al-Suffa, and those sahaba, they all sat down in a line. So when they sat down in a line, Hazrat Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu was commanded by our holy prophet to give the bowl of milk to each sahaba to drink. So in total, 70 sahaba drank from this bowl of milk, but the bowl of milk, the milk inside of it wouldn't finish. All 70 of them would drink it to their heart's content, and still there was a lot of milk left. Then after everyone has drank, our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Hazrat Abu Hurairah that it is just me and you who is left, who has not yet drank milk. So then Hazrat our holy prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told Hazrat Abu Hurairah, now sit down and it is your turn to drink the milk. So Hazrat Abu Hurairah, he drank the milk to his heart's content, but then he was giving it to our Holy Prophet. Our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, drink more. Drink more, and then when Hazrat Abu Huraira was so full, he then told our Holy Prophet that I am now full and I cannot drink more. So then our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, finally he at last got the bowl of milk and he drank it, and then the milk, it finished. So that is the waqia of the milk bowl and Hazrat Abu Huraira. We can see that much patience that Hazrat Abu Huraira has displayed in this story by obeying our Holy Prophet, giving the milk to everyone before himself. So he gave the milk to other people before, and then at last he drank it himself without questioning our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the mu'jiza is displayed by our Holy Prophet that the milk would not end. So did you guys understand this story?
Yes.
Okay, I hope you did, because now there are questions. So you guys can raise up your hand to answer these questions, and here is the very first one. What is the name of the Sahaba who felt hungry? Maz?
Hazrat Humaira radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. You are close. And question number two, what is the name of the two Sahaba that Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Abu Huraira asked for the translation of the ayah? Abdul Hadi, do you know?
I forgot one, but I know the second one, Hazrat Umar.
Yes, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And does anyone could name the first one? Yes, Mas.
Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
Yes, Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And here is our next question. Who is the one who brought Hazrat Abu Huraira to their home? Muina, do you have an idea? Yes, our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the one who brought Hazrat Abu Huraira. And what was in the bowl and how many Sahaba drank from it? Aisha?
There was milk in the bowl and 70 Sahaba drank from it.
Yes, there was milk in the bowl and 70 Sahaba drank from it. And what is the meaning of Ashabi Sufa? Like, what is this place? Muina, do you know?
Just know a little bit. Sahabi Sufa means like a little staff where Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq came. Right, with Prophet Muhammad
is
in Medina?
Yes, it is located in Medina. It is a platform where a bunch of Sahaba, they took Al-Madin from our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the place that they they learned from, the place that they used to sit around, it's a square. It is known as Ashabi Sufa. Okay, what is the moral or the lesson of this story that you guys took? Yes, Abdul Hadi?
That we should always give stuff to people before we take it, and
yes,
be kind.
Yes, we should always think about other people before we think about ourselves. And anyone else? Yes, Moina?
We should be sabr, and we should first give someone else, then we should eat and
do. Yes, yes, we should be very, very patient when doing the stuff, the thing that Abdul Hadi just mentioned. And anyone else? Yes, Mas?
You should give food to people who are hungry.
Yes, that is correct. Those are all lessons that we can learn from this story. I hope you guys enjoyed that segment. Now moving on to our bonus question round. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so for one question, whoever raises up their hand first will be selected. Okay, and for each question, you guys have a chance to answer. But if you guys do not answer correctly, you will not have another chance at that question. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Okay, here is question number one. What and where is the second tallest mountain in the world? Ooh, this is close, but I think I saw Maz's hand first.
K2 is the second tallest, and it is located in Pakistan.
Yes, the mountain K2 is located in Pakistan. Question number two. How many states does India have? Ooh, I think that was a Muina.
So India has 29 states and 7 union territories.
You are correct. Okay, how many seasons do Pakistan and India have? Maz, I saw your hand first.
There are 5 seasons: winter, spring, summer, monsoon, and fall.
Yes, you are correct. Okay, And what is the national flower of India and Pakistan? Oh, Abdul Hadi, your hand shot up quite fast.
The national flower of Pakistan is jasmine and India's national flower is lotus.
Is the lotus flower. You are correct. And our very last question. Which city in Pakistan is known as the port of Pakistan? Everyone answered except for Aisha, so I'm going to give this one to Aisha.
Karachi is known as the port of Pakistan.
Yes, Karachi is known as the port of Pakistan. So, well then, that ends off our bonus question round and our storytelling round. After the break, we will have our guessing game, so stay tuned for that.
درود و سلام کی صداؤں سے بھرپور اللہ پاک کی رحمتوں کا نزول پریشانیوں اور مسائل کے حل کے لیے دیکھتے رہیے میم ٹی وی
اللہم صل علی سیدنا محمد
پنج وقت اذان و درود و دعا درس قرآن و ذکر رسول و خدا اہل بیت و صحابہ کا بھی تذکرہ دین حق کا سکھانا سلامت رہے دین حق کا سکھانا سلامت رہے میم کا ایسا جذبہ سلامت رہے میم کا ایسا جذبہ سلامت رہے
دیکھتے رہیے آپ کا اپنا میم ٹی وی
اللہم صلی وسلم وبارک
دیکھتے رہیے ہمارے ساتھ میم ٹی وی
السلام علیکم ورحمت اللہ وبرکاتہ We are now back from our short break and now we have our guessing game Are you guys ready for this?
Yes
So there will be a question and you guys can answer. Hints will be provided. So don't hesitate to ask me for any hints. So here is our very first question. What are animals that can see at night called? Muina?
Owl.
No, they're not called owls. Owl is one of the animals that can see at night. Anyone else know what they're called? The animals that can see at night, that are awake during night. I don't think I worded that properly. Yes, Maz?
Wolves?
No, they're not called wolves. The animals that can, stay awake during the night. There are animals like humans, we stay awake during the day and we sleep at night. Do you know an animal that has this cycle but in opposite? Like, do you guys know what are they called? What is the name for it? Is it, do you guys know, yes, Muina?
Wait, can you just tell us the first word?
It's just one word. I can tell you guys a hint. It starts with the letter N. Yes, Maz? It's okay if you guys don't know. The answer is Abdul Hadi.
Night owl.
No, they are called nocturnal animals. Animals that can see and that they stay awake during the night, they are called nocturnal. Okay, question number two. What is the closest planet to the sun? Aisha? It is not the closest. Maz?
Neptune?
No, it is more farther away. Abdul Hadi.
Earth?
Earth is the third closest or the fourth. I can't exactly remember. I think it's the fourth, yes.
Jupiter? Muina?
No, Jupiter is also far away. Okay, the answer... Oh, Aisha?
Venus?
No, it is close, but the answer is actually Mercury. It is also the smallest planet and it is the closest to our sun. Okay, what do you call an animal that can live on land and on the water? This should be fairly easy, Maz.
Frogs?
No, they're not all known as frogs. Crocodiles aren't called frogs. Muina?
Turtles?
No.
They're crocodiles?
No. Aisha? Like, I'm talking about the general name. What do you guys call them?
Amphibians?
Yes, Aisha. They are known as amphibians. Okay, what direction does the sun rise in? Abdul Hadi?
Up.
It rises up, but do you guys know which direction? Like north, south, east, west? Muina?
I think it's west.
No, I'm sorry, it is not west, Maz.
East.
Yes, it is the east. Okay, now this is our very last question for our guessing game round. Who knows the most important date of the month of Muharram? The most important date that we see during the month of Muharram. Do you guys know the date of it? I'll tell you guys the name. The day of Ashura. Do you guys know which date it falls upon? Abdul Hadi?
I think it's the last one.
It is 30? It is not the 30th. Aisha?
11th?
It is not the 11th, but very, very close.
12?
No, it's not the 12. 11 is the closest answer we got so far, Maz.
10?
Yes, it is the 10th. 10th of Muharram is known as the day of Ashura. So on the day of Ashura, it is very, very close to when this program is being recorded. So we should make sure that we fast on the day of Ashura and one of the days before, like the 9th or the day after 11th. More details on that in our next program, Inshallah Azawajal. So stay tuned for that. Well then, that ends off our program. Now, before we end it off, we always give gifts to our participants. So let's bring the gifts for our participants today. So as you guys can see, all of these gifts here are for me. I have four gifts. No, I'm just kidding. They are for our participants. Starting with you, Aisha. MashaAllah, you did a very good job. So did you, Muina. So did you, Abdul Hadi.
Jazakallah.
And Maz, you also did an amazing
job. Jazakallah.
So subhanAllah to all of you guys for participating in this program. I hope we all got to learn something new. And inshallah azawajal, we all can apply what we learned. As always, a special thanks to the producers at Meme TV for making this program possible. Until next time, remember us in your prayers. Stay tuned and keep watching Meme TV.
Fahashi aur music se paak, gunahon se bachane wala, aapka apna Meme TV.
We're going to be learning, reading namaz and all sorts of Islamic things.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
Namaz, Qiyamah ki dhoom mein saaya hai.
There's learning time and sunnah time and praying time and naaz time. There's always such a great time and it's mini meme time. It's mini meme time with Umeza. It's mini meme time with Umeza.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد